The changing of the guard on Syntagma Square in front of the Greek Parliament. Just days ago, the square was filled with demonstrators rallying for a yes or no in the referendum. Now the tourists have returned. Though there's no end in sight to the crisis, Greeks remain confident.
I don't think anything's going to change in the near future. If the politicians take the right steps, Greece should be back on top in 2 or 3 years.
Well, things will calm down. Tsipras has stabilized his power and now has the chance to do what he wants and must do. It gives the government greater stability.
And greater stability is something that 3 million Greeks without health insurance are hoping for. Most can't afford to pay for medications themselves and rely on volunteer organizations like the Metropolitan Community Clinic on the outskirts of Athens. All of its staff are unpaid. A donated shipment of medication has just arrived from Hamburg. Here, the tablets are sorted and checked before being given out to those in need. But there's still a shortage of very pricey drugs, including those used to treat cancer.
The budget for health has decreased more than 48% since 2009, and this is up to December 2014. At any given moment, it can collapse. If we don't increase the funds for it, things will get worse.
The Greek state has no money. The country's economy has been decimated. Many factories have shut down, temporarily or for good. There's one exception, this brewery. Its owners have invested more than 4.2 million euros in new canning equipment. Things are still in the testing stage. The investment was made possible through vendor financing from the machine's German manufacturer. A loan protection policy will cover payments should the brewery find itself in financial trouble. The plant's machinery was old and outmoded. But the new equipment has made the brewery competitive again.
So for us it was a way either to stop or to continue. Yeah, it's a huge investment compared to the environment of Greece at this moment, which is unstable. This is a big risk financially. But also we are thinking of trying to expose ourselves to the export.
Small and medium-sized companies are the foundation stones of the Greek economy. So far, this family business has survived Greece's economic crisis. It has a government license to make reproductions of antique Greek vases. They're a big hit with tourists. 50% of those made are exported. The firm's owner hopes that, strengthened by the referendum results, the Tsipras government will reform Greece's tax system. That would create a more attractive climate for small businesses.
The cost of doing business in Greece is too high. Some firms can keep their heads above water since they have years of market experience, but others are forced to close. With a sales tax of 23%, a tax rate that starts at 26%, and advanced tax payments of 55%, how can companies hope to survive? Small firms have it really hard, and that's why we need financial assistance. Without that, it's barely doable. How can you run a profitable company under these conditions without economic support?
His biggest supplier is a company from the same district. This family business makes the vases which are later painted. Potter Yanis Franciscus hopes the Tsipras government won't make the same mistakes as the previous ones.
The problem is the partisan politics. The parties create posts for their supporters as civil servants, to the detriment of the private sector, especially small and medium-sized companies.
In front of the Greek parliament, the changing of the guard always goes off without a hitch. Now Greece must finally implement much-needed reforms to keep in step with the rest of the EU.